Good afternoon, friends. Today we are here in the series of lectures, microbiology, and BISEC is the way how to means to teach you with the help of this new aid. Myself, Rikin Parikh. I am from Khambat Science College. With me is Mr. Pankaj C. Gandhi. And Gandhi Sahib is from M.B. Patel Science College, Anand. So today we both will try to give you some idea regarding the topic which is named as it is given in the slide or in the title, that is microbiology of milk. So milk na vishay ni microbiology mate we'll discuss today. So we both of us will try to give you a good idea about milk, microbiology of milk, the microorganisms which can be present, how they are harmful or useful for the human beings and for the consumption of human beings. So several aspects related with microbiology of milk that we are going to discuss today with all of you, and I hope that all of you will enjoy this lecture and will have a good learning experience throughout our lecture. So first of all, I will request now Gandhi sir to give you primary background and guideline about the same topic. Gandhi sir.
Hello, good afternoon to all of you. Now first of all, I discuss about what is the milk and the definition of the milk and the introduction regarding the milk. Now milk is a normal secretion, lacteal secretion obtained from the mammary glands of the mammals, and it is a complete food for the human beings, and it is also a nutritive cultural medium for the microorganisms. Now milk is also a complete food. It is referred as a complete food because it contains a lot of microorganisms, lots of ingredients which are having the lactose sugar, then casein protein, then butter fat, then minerals, as well as the water content in the form of 87.3%, and there are also albumin and globulin, like the proteins molecules are also present. Now the pH of the milk is also a 6.7 to 6.9. Now here the specific gravity of the milk is 1.035. Now here the most of the nutrients are present in the form of the vitamins, minerals, lactose sugars, and the total solids, then the whey proteins, mineral salts, vitamins, and enzymes. So that's why the human beings used milk as a complete food, and as well as the microorganisms can also use as a complete nutritive medium. Here the microorganisms can utilize the in the form of carbon and nitrogen source as a lactose and caseins respectively, and they will multiply and reproduce in the milk. So that's why, due to this reason, the milk is referred as a best culture medium for the microorganisms. Now first of all, see about the composition of the milk, and now the normal and abnormal flora of the milk. Now there are innumerous numbers of bacteria, then yeast, molds, and the bacteriophages are present in the milk sample. Now the various types of the milk samples are analyzed, and first of all, in the raw milk, there is a presence of a bacteria belonging to the four main groups. First is the gram-positive cocci, and gram-positive cocci including especially the Streptococcus lactis, Streptococcus cremoris, then Micrococcus luteus, and Micrococcus variens. Now, the another group of microorganisms of the bacteria is a gram-positive non-spore-forming rods, and which includes examples are the Lactobacillus casei, Lactobacillus bulgaricus, Lactobacillus acidophilus, and Lactobacillus fermentum. Now third groups include, and which are the gram-positive spore-forming rods, including a Bacillus subtilis, Bacillus cereus,
Clostridium botulinum and Clostridium butyricum. Here the Clostridium botulinum and Clostridium butyricum, which are the anaerobic spore forming rods, while the Bacillus subtilis and Bacillus cereus are the aerobic spore formers. Now the fourth groups include the gram negative non spore forming rods, where includes a E. coli, Escherichia coli, Enterobacter aeruginosa, and Pseudomonas zinxanta. Now the second main group, or the main group present in the milk, is the yeast, that is the Torula lactis and Torula cremoris. Groups of the yeast species are also present, and they will produce acid as well as gas in the raw milk. Now the fourth, third group, that is the molds, where the Penicillium and Aspergillus, they are growing in the milk, and they will utilize the milk as a nutritive medium, and they produce a fluzzy or the fluffy type of a growth in the milk. Now the fourth group includes the bacteriophages. Sometimes, or the rare cases, the bacteriophages are also inserted or the introduced in the milk via the contaminating organisms, and they will clear the milk sample where the specific bacterial host cells are present. Next slide.
So now I will continue with the other topic. You all had understood very well that what is milk, what is the composition of milk, and why the milk is a very good source for the organisms, that is I mean to say that is microorganisms as well as the human beings. As we have discussed that milk possesses casein, that is a proteinic material which is present almost in milk, and the other is the lactose, that is a sugar which is present mainly into the milk, as well as different minerals are present, and vitamins are also present in some small quantities. So these are the reasons why milk is a best medium for the growth of bacteria also, as well as the consumption or consuming for the human beings also. But as we can understand, if we consume milk in our daily diet, then it will going to provide the nutrients what is being possessed by milk, but the risk factors are also there. So that we have to consider, that what are the risk factors. Means there are largely two varieties of different types of the bacteria or microorganisms which are present into the milk. One, you will say that they are harmful to the human body, and the other type is beneficial to the human body. So we have to eliminate the harmful varieties of the bacteria from the milk, and then we should consume that, so that cannot harm to our body. So first of all, to understand that aspect, we will discuss that how the milk is been spoiled, that is called as a spoilage of milk, that how milk will be spoiled. So to understand that, we have to understand that total channel via which the milk is coming to our homes, means to the consumers from the producers. It has been produced by the mammillary glands animals, and ultimately it will come in a pack of some jar or polypack or something like that. In that form it will reaches to our home. So this is a chain. Now spoilage of milk, so in that regards, so it is a very perishable food. That's what I mean to say. Perishable means it is most likely to have such several type of organisms can invade it and can spoil the natural quality of the milk. Milk is an ideal food for the microbial invasions. That's what I discussed earlier also, that for observing the microbial biological quality of the milk, we have to study the supply chain. That's what I told you earlier, we have to understand the supply chain. So in this slide you can also see that UHT milk supply chain. What first that question will come to your mind, that why this UHT has been written. That UHT stands for ultra heat treatment done milk. Means normally whatever the milk is been supplied to us, that is been treated largely, and it is a treated milk. I will discuss the same thing in a later part, that what is ultra heat treatment, but right now we will move further with this chain, in which is clearly indicating that milking process, transportation to the collection center, then it is been hold for temporary period of time, that is a holding and a storage. Then after, it has been transported to the industry. Industry means to the dairy or something like that. That is Amul dairy or whatever the dairy, it is giving the treatment to the raw milk. The reception by the dairy or the industry, then processing is been done and packaging is been done of the milk which has been supplied to them, and then they will store once again them, and then they do the marketing. So this is the overall supply chain, and there are all the chances of contamination in each step what we have discussed. Now in next slide, it is a very good slide, will give you the idea that in different areas from which the milk can be contaminated. So in the middle you can see that are the sources of contamination in the milk, means these all the scattered balloons what I had given you in the chart, that is the animal body surface, the surface of the animal body by which the milking is been done. Then air, obviously air considers and contains so many different varieties of large amount of microorganisms. Then odors, milkman who is doing the milking process, water, it is very important part, feed, the feed means the feed what the animal is taking, and then soil, the soil is the area where the ML is living, and then equipments and utensils. These are also very important aspects, that in every area we have to consider that you should minimize the chance of contamination. You should take care in each and every step of the milking process, means milking process includes the milking from the cow or any mammal, and then the all chain what we have discussed. So throughout that chain, throughout these all are becoming the sources by which the contamination can occur and our milk can be spoiled. So this was about that. Now this is some animations and some pictures which will give you the routine idea that how the milk can be contaminated. So you first picture you can understand that cow is having its food from the garbage area. So it gives you clear idea that if this type of the food will be consumed by the cow or any other mammal, and then after it will deliver the milk, then you can think about the quality of the milk. So you should avoid that. The utensils and the things which has been used for carrying the milk, that has to be particularly you can say sterilized. You cannot do sterilization for all this type of things, but you can take care also, so sanitation or this type of the things can be done. And these are the various areas why where the things can be spoiled. So every stages there can be the spoilage. Now we'll go and have a quick look at the type of the bacteria which will be giving contamination in the different area. First, the predominant types of microorganisms from the milk handlers, the persons who are doing the handling of the milk, in from him this type of the bacteria can invade, that is E. coli, Vibrio cholerae, Shigella dysentery, hepatitis virus. So these are the possible organisms which can invade. Now predominant types of microorganism from the inside the animals. Animal is you can understand that it is having so many tissues and so many different organisms can be there in the animal area. So Micrococcus species, Streptococcus, Corynebacterium and Staphylococcus, these are the type of the organisms which can spoil our milk also. Now the predominant types of microorganism from the feed, soil and water, what it is being consumed by the organism cow. That is the lactic acid bacteria, coliforms. Coliforms include Salmonella group, Staphylococcus and Micrococcus luteus species and all. So these are the various types of the things which can be done by this equipments which are used by the milking persons and all. So that is the organisms are like this: gram-negative rods, that is Pseudomonas, alkaligens, Flavobacterium, gram-positive Micrococcus, Enterobacteria species. So these so many different types of species can be contaminated and give contamination and that is comes from the equipments. Now ultra heated treated milk is also can be contaminated by Bacillus cereus or Bacillus stearothermophilus or sporothermodons and psychrophilic bacillus species. The pathogenic varieties of the milk. Pathogen includes, well, first of all, let me give you this idea that the word pathogen. This word, as you all now are the familiar with the terminologies of microbiology, but it is still needed to consider this small word that is pathogen. Pathogen is a word by which you can understand pathogen means organism which can cause disease, right? So that way you can bifurcate the organism that which is helpful for us, which is harmful for us. It gives harms in this way that the organism which can give disease. So if the organism is disease causing, then it is referred to be as a pathogen. So every time you have to understand that every pathogen is associated with a particular type of disease. Now I am in this particular slide and this tabular chart, I will try to explain you that which organism or which pathogen is related with which type of the disease which is commonly found in the human beings. So Mycobacterium tuberculosis, this is the most heard name I think from all of you, that tuberculosis is a disease by with which this Mycobacterium is been associated. Then Brucella, it gives the brucellosis. Staphylococcus aureus, it is giving to the diarrhea, vomiting. E. coli, it is leads to the diarrhea. Salmonella typhi, it is going to give you a typhoid type of fever. Vibrio cholerae, it is going to cause you the cholera. Clostridium botulinum, it is a toxin producing organism and will give you the harmful toxins. Hepatitis virus, it is going to harm in a way that it is going to do hepatitis to the human beings. Shigella dysentery, it is going to give the dysentery or diarrhea type of the disease. So these all diseases are very commonly found, and now you should be able to understand that by consuming this type of the infected or contaminated milk also, you can go for some various type of the diseases also. So we have to be very much aware about these all type of the invasions and spoilage of the back milk. Now these are the varieties, another varieties as we have discussed, all bacterial species are there. I tried to give you the staining of, these are the staining of Mycobacterium. And another is the Bacillus cereus, it's a stained slide for that. So you can have the idea under the microscope with a stain, bacteria looks like this. So to give you that idea. Now if the spoilage is been there in the raw milk, then also it's going to give which type of the activity that is been discussed in this slide, that by Pseudomonas, it is going to give the metabolize the proteins. So it will act upon the protein. Obviously now you understand that milk protein is casein, so it is going to denature that and give the disease. Species of some psychrotrophs, that is going to metabolize proteins once again. Coliforms, they are going to metabolize lactose. So coliforms are the group of organisms which found in the intestinal colons of the human body, and most of the very common examples for coliforms are E. coli, Enterobacter and all. So the nature of the coliforms are what? That they are going to utilize sugar, and as you know, the sugar in a milk is lactose sugar. So they will degrade lactose and convert it into the lactic acid, and further degradation occurs. So it is going to produce acids into the milk. So this type of the activity has been done by that. And the other species, they are also going to spoil our milk in some different ways. So these are the examples: Lactobacillus, Enterococcus, Micrococcus, Bacillus and Clostridium are the examples of others. So now I have discussed about the so many different types of the organisms which are going to spoil your quality of the milk. Now we will go and become somewhat more specified, specific, that how will we will discriminate that spoilage once again. So on the basis of the nature, how the spoilage has been done, then first thing which has been caused or which is the type of the spoilage. So firstly I will explain you about the ropiness. It is a type of the spoilage which is done in the milk.
by such type of organisms which are doing the slime and sticky layer of polysaccharides excreted by the microorganisms on the milk surface. Means the milk, the organisms are indigenous into the milk, but they are going to produce certain type of the slimy layer on the surface of the milk. So it, you will find that type of the ropiness into the milk. So it is a one type of the spoilage, and this type of the spoilage is been done with the help of the organisms. Such the organism names are written, that is the alkaligens, viscolacticus and enterobacter aerogens. So these are the examples of the organisms which are going to give you the type of ropiness. So your milk will become like this. So as in the glass, you will find in the slide, you can understand that the milk, the you just observe the surface of the milk, that this surface is become a very slimy and fluffy, and this type of the things will be appeared or observed in the milk, and that is known as the ropiness of the milk. So it's a first variety. The other variety, the other category is known as a proteolysis. As the name indicate, proteolysis, lysis means breakdown, and breakdown of the protein. So what do you mean by that? The first line indicates that proteolysis is the hydrolysis of the milk protein by the microorganism. As we now understand that casein is a type of variety, that type of protein which is present, and it is been degraded by the organisms. This result into the development of the bitter flavor. How you will know? It is the function of the microbiologist to understand and analyze that which type of the spoilage has been done. I will say that spoilage is ropiness or proteolysis, but how the common man will understand that what type of the spoilage has been done? Then by this means you can understand that how, if the proteolysis occurs, then you will find bitterness into the milk. It is favored by the low temperature. Means also you can understand, for preservation of milk, normally we are doing refrigeration in our homes, but it in this case you can have that idea that at low temperature this type of the proteolysis can also becomes faster. And examples of the organisms which can do this type of the proteolysis are Micrococcus, Clostridium and Bacillus groups. So heat stable enzymes of psychrotrophs. Now this is some other variety of the organism, psychrotroph. What do you mean by psychrotroph? The psychrotrophs are the troph, means to love. They will love to grow at psychro, means low temperature. They will love to grow at low temperature. So you preserve it at low temperature, and at that temperature also the organisms will grow into the milk and spoil your milk. So we have to be aware, and we have to take care of that type of the organisms also. So this is also one of the aspect. And other thing what I want to explain you, that how they will spoil your milk, that is they possesses that type of the enzyme which will spoil your quality of the milk. So in this table you can understand that how it will going to give that type of the spoilage. So two types of the protein mainly it possesses, that is one is a proteases and other are the lipases. If the organism what I discussed, they are having this type of the proteases, what will they do? They will degrade the casein. Casein is a milk protein, and what type of the effect they will produce? So rather I have written defect, means it is not a effect, but due to that effect it is become defected. The quality of the milk has been defected. So it has been written that it has been you can say judge or understood by the common man by this defects, that your milk become bitter in flavor, the putrefied flavor, and coagulation also occurs. The lipases, so lipases will act upon lipids, so they will degrade lipid. So that is been written, that action which will be exhibited by this type of the variety of the enzymes, that is degradation of fat globule. So that is been fat is been degraded, and what type of the defect will be observed, that is the lipolysis and flavor will affected due to that type of the activity of the enzyme. So this is one also other variety of the microorganisms which will is going to spoil your milk. So spoilage is very important. Now what we have referred, that is for the raw milk, that raw milk is being spoiled by this type of the varieties. Now ultra heated treatment type of the milk is also can be spoiled, and some bacillus species that can be survived after this ultra heat treatment also, they are bacillus cereus, bacillus porothermophilus, and the cold storage of the pasteurized milk, and psychrophilic bacillus, sweet curdling bacteria, action of the heat resistant proteases and lipases can be produced. So this type of the things can be observed, this type of the spoilages can be observed also in this type of the UHT milk. Now to overcome our spoilage, what are the treatment, what are the preservation plans or preservation ideas? The first thing which comes in our mind, that is what, that is the process of pasteurization. So you all know that you will collectively say, sir, pasteurization is the process by which you can make the milk free from different type of organisms, because it, this term is become very popular. But now it is our my try to explain you that what actually the pasteurization mean. So first thing in which comes in your mind, that is what, that why the name is pasteurization. So let me clarify, it is the technique which has been invented by the scientist known as, very renowned scientist, the Nobel laureate scientist is Louis Pasteur. So he has done the remarkable achievements and investigations in the field of microbiology. But this particular term is been denoted by the name of the Louis Pasteur. The term is pasteurization. So how will you define this term? The term pasteurization means it is a heating of each and every particle of milk at 145 degree Fahrenheit, and you have to hold that temperature, you hold the milk at that temperature for 30 minutes. It was a prior practice, right? And it is named as a long time holding, right? That is a long time method. So 30 minutes you have to carry the same temperature, and you have to carry the milk at that particular temperature. So what happens due to that? Due to this treatment, pathogenic varieties of the milk will be removed. So that is the difference between heating, that is a normal heating, and pasteurization. As you understand, if we boil the milk, what happens? It will, it is a 100 degree Celsius temperature, and they will try to kill organisms randomly, right? But it is a selective type of the killing by which you can have that type of the difference, that pathogenic varieties will be killed. So because we want some good type of the bacteria to remain survive into the milk, that is the reason why we are selecting pasteurization, not all the time heating, or you can say boiling has been done. So pasteurization will destroy the all pathogens that we have mentioned earlier also. This method was, as I discussed, it has been invented by the Pasteur. Then there are several methods. The name of the methods are there. That is known as LTH, that is low temperature holding long time, HTST, that is a high temperature for short time, and ultra high temperature, that is UHT. That's what we were discussing from last 10-15 slides, that high temperature short time, that is the time temperature relationship is what, that is 71.9 degree Celsius for 15 seconds, that is span is shorter. And in low temperature, low time, that is a low temperature, that is 63 degree Celsius, but the temperature is for the longer period of time, that is a 63 degree Celsius for the 30 minutes. And now ultra high temperature, it refers that 148.9 degree Celsius for 2-3 seconds. So if we do this type of the treatment, then it is a sort of amazing type of the treatment, because after this you will not need to refrigerate it also. So that is the beauty of this type of the treatment. So this type of the treatment should be done, and they are required to overcome the spoilage of the milk. So once again, if we want to analyze that, we have discussed that this type of the treatments are used for pasteurization, but pasteurization is been done properly or not. if we are confused with that, which is the technique, which is a method used for the exact pasteurization is done or not, the method is known as a phosphatase test. With the phosphatase test, it's been carried out, and the detail part will be discussed by Gandhi sir, but I will give you some basic idea that phosphatase test is done for the pasteurization. Why it is done? Phosphatase is a name of the enzyme, it is a type of the enzyme which is normally present into the mammals. Now, so it is there into the milk, but due to the process of pasteurization, this phosphatase is been inactivated or killed after the process of pasteurization. So we will going to estimate or measure that the amount of phosphatase is present or not. So if we find that the phosphatase is still present, then you can conclude that the pasteurization process what we have done, that was not proper. And if we find that there is no phosphatase, then you can say that the pasteurization was done in a correct manner. So this is one method by which you can identify that pasteurization is done in a proper manner or not. So these are the things. Now the ultimate thing is what? That is sterilization, and that we have discussed also. It is also known as the ultra high temperature treatment. That is now commercial techniques is been done in this way, and this is the same thing. That is the 300 degree Fahrenheit is the temperature, and for that 1 to 2 seconds you just have to put that milk, and now you not need to refrigerate it. So nowadays whatever the commercially available Tetra Pak milk is available into the market, that is this type of the sterilization is been done in the type of the milk, so you can preserve it for a longer period of time. And if you cannot do refrigeration, then also this can be a good quality milk you can consume up to 10-15 days. So this type of the thing is been observed by this. So this is some methods. Now microbiological analysis of milk. So now this topic will be discussed by Gandhi sir, that how we'll measure the or analyze that which type of the organisms are present, and what is the quality and what is the quantity of them, and what are the methodologies which are used for the analysis of the milk. That has been discussed by Gandhi sir. So please sir.
Now in the microbiological analysis of milk, now there are a enormous number of microorganisms are introduced into the raw milk, and after the pasteurization process, the how many organisms are surviving, and that analysis will be carried out by the two different kinds of bacteriological methods. And first, that is the quantitative analysis, and secondly, it is a quantitative analysis. Now two different kinds of analysis has been carried out in the microbiological laboratory in the dairy industries. Now first I discuss about the quantitative analysis of milk. Now quantitative analysis of milk includes a standard plate count or the total viable counts. Here the whatever the living bacteria are present either in the raw milk or pasteurized milk, that will be enumerated or the calibrated by the SPC method or the total viable count method. Now here the milk sample is taken, and that will be diluted in the form of 10^-1, 10^-2, and 10^-3. That means the various dilutions of the milk sample is to be prepared, because we are not knowing the actual load of microorganisms or the bacteria are present in the given milk sample. So here first of all, the how they prepare the various dilutions 10^-1, 10^-2, and 10^-3. Now first of all, take the 0.5 ml milk sample by using the sterile 1 ml pipette, and that will be inoculated into the 4.5 ml of sterile distilled water vials. Mix it properly. That means here the distributions of microorganisms or the bacteria present in the raw or the pasteurized milk, they are uniformly distributed into the distilled water, sterile distilled water, and that will make the 10^-1 dilution. Now 10^-1, from the 10^-1 dilution you have to just prepare the 10^-2 dilution. So from the 10^-1 dilution you have to take 0.5 ml of the diluted milk sample
milk sample, and that will be added into the 4.5 ml of the sterile distilled water. That will make the 10^-2 dilutions. Then afterwards, same ways, you have to take 0.5 ml of the diluted milk sample from the 10^-2, and that will be added into 4.5 ml sterile distilled water, and that will make the 10^-3. Now there is a preparation of the various dilutions, like the 10^-1, 10^-2, and 10^-3. That means the distributions of uniformly distribution of organism is there, and from the each dilution you have to take the 1 ml of the diluted sample, and that will be inoculated into the sterile melted agar medium. And here the precaution is to be taken that the sterile melted agar temperature is to be adjusted 45 degree centigrade, not above the 45 degree centigrade, because the above 45 degree centigrade temperature the organisms becomes killed, because there are the mesophilic one. Most of the organisms present in the mills are the psychrophilic or the mesophilic one, and the mesophilic organisms are killed. So that's why the temperature should be adjusted 45 degree centigrade. So from the each dilution you have to take 1 ml of the milk sample, and that will be inoculated into the sterile melted agar, and that will be poured into the separate sterile empty petri plate. Then allow it to solidify at the room temperature. After solidification of the medium, incubate the plates at 37 degree centigrade in the incubator for 24 hours. After 24 hours, from the each dilution containing plates, count the number of bacteria present or the number of colony forming units per ml of undiluted milk sample. So by this way, we can count the or the enumerate the number of bacteria present in the 1 ml of undiluted raw, either raw or the pasteurized milk. So this is the first method. Here the only the living bacterial are enumerated. Here the dead organisms are non-enumerated. That is the main advantages of this technique. It is a rapid technique and widely used in the dairy industries. Now the second method is a direct microscopic method. It is also a rapid method. Here you have to take a clean neat slide and prepare one square centimeter area at the center part of the clean neat slide, and then 0.01 ml of the milk sample is taken, and that will be spreaded over the one square centimeter area. Allow it to air dry. Do not fix it with heat. But here this air dry smear is stained with the methylene blue or the Jensen violet, and for the 1 minute or the 1 to 2 minutes, and allow it to wash with the slide. Wash the slide with the water and then allow it to air dry.
Lastly, we will conclude our proceedings, as we are running short with the time, that cheese making is the fermented food products, right? So fermented food products will be the things in that category. We can have the making of cheese and butter and all other varieties. As I have discussed that we are running short with the time, so I am concluding this, that this is the area where the milk is been fermented, and fermented food products are also used. So these are the reference books from which we have considered these all things, and for our preparation we have referred this type of the recommendation books, and this is our these are our web email IDs. So if you are having some queries, you can give us a mail, and we will try to make you clear about that. So thank you very much for hearing us patiently, and that's it. Thank you very much.
Thank you.